and welcome to Ganesh's YouTube channel. So today we are going to discuss that how we can find out the value of a function with the help of Maclaurin's theorem. So with the help of Maclaurin's theorem, the formula is for finding fx, f of 0 means the value of function at point 0, plus x of first derivative having value 0, then I mean, you have to put 0 in terms of variable and keep going with 2 factorial, 3 factorial, here x square, x cube, x raised to power 4, single differentiable, derivative, double derivative, triple derivative, and so on. Okay, so let's see how we can expand using this formula. Expand 10x up to the term containing x raised to power 5. So let's see. So, you know, there it is x, x raised to power 2, x raised to power 3. So, we have to expand until x raised to power 5. Okay, let's begin. So, first of all, your function is 10x. So, at x as 0, 10, 0, we know it is 1, 0. Right? 10, 0 is 0. Now, you need to find out first derivative, second derivative, third derivative, up to fifth derivative. Right? So, first derivative. For 10x, it is 6 square x. And you can write it as 1 plus 10 square x, right? So, your single derivative at point 0 will be, this would become 0. 10, 0 is 0 and it is 1. Right? 1 is left. Thereafter, double derivative. So, this is your function. So, for 1, it is 0. Now, derivative of x square, apply chain rule. X square is 2x, x is 10x here, and derivative of 10x is 6 square x. Now, what you can do, you can put 1 plus 10 square x, because this is the formula. So, this will become 210x plus 210 cube x, right? Now, again, when you will put, this is your second derivative. You will put f double derivative as 0. I mean, the value of x as 0. So, 210, 0, 0, 210, 0, again 0. Triple derivative. So, it will be 2. For 10x, it is 6 square x plus 2. Again, chain rule. Let's say this is x cube. So, for x cube, it is 3x square. Now, the derivative of the value x which you have assumed. So, for 10x, it is 6 square x, right? So, 2 sec square x plus 3 times 2 is 6, 10 square x. You can write it as 1 plus 10 square x, right? The formula. So, in this way, again here also you can write 1 plus 10 square x. Right? So, 2 times 1 is 2, 2 10 square x, 6 10 square x, 6 10 raised to power 4 x, right? So, for triple derivative at x is equals to 0, your value will be 0 0 0, 10 0 is 0, what is left? Only 2. Then after fourth derivative, you can write it as this as well. Okay. Again, take derivative of this. So, 2 for 2 is 0. 2. This is x square. So, 2x and thereafter for x it is 6 square x, right? Here, this is, you can take it as 6 plus 2, 8. 8, 10x. 8, 10 square x all together, right? So, 8 is here. Value of x square is 2x. And for x, this is 6 square x, right? Plus, 6 times 4 is 24. Because you are taking this as capital X. So, x raised to power 4. Derivative of this is 4x cube. So, 4. 6 times 4 is 24. X cube. Now, because you have assumed that your x is 10x, so for that, derivative is 6 square x, right? So, 8 times 2 is 16, 10x, you can put it as 1 plus 10 square x, plus 24, 10 cube x. Again, this is 1 plus 10 square x, right? Again, distribute. 16 times 1, 16, 10x plus 16, 10 cube x. Base same power adding multiplication. 24, 10 cube x plus 24, 10 raised to power 5x, right? Thereafter, like terms can be added. So 16 and 24, 6 or 4, 10, 40. 40, 10 cube x, right? So, f raised to power 4, if you put, let me write it here, 24, 10 raised to power 5x. So, if you want its value at 0, every term has got 10x, so 10, 0 is 0. Thereafter, fifth derivative, 16, for 10x it is 6 square x plus, this is your x cube, so 40 times 3 is 120, 10 square x. And for 10x it is 6 square x. 24 times 5. 5 4 is 20. 5 is 120. 10 raised to power 4x. And for 10 it is again 6 square x. Right? Thereafter, if you put here the value of 6 square x as 1 plus 10 square x. 120. Let it be 6 square x only. So, now if you put the value of x as 0, you will see 16 times 1 is 16. Rest all will have 10x, right? So, because that's why I didn't change it. So, because rest all have 10x, so everything will be 0 except this 16. So, on putting x as 0, you will get the value of f raised to power 5 as 16, right? So, on putting down all these values into this, your f0 is 0, okay, plus x, your f dash 0 is 1, plus x square by 2 factorial. You know how to solve factorials? 2 times 1. So, 2, f double dash 0 is 0, so it is 0. Let's not write 0. Thereafter, x cube by 3 factorial means 3 into 2 into 1. So, 6. F triple dash. What is F triple dash? 0. It is 2. Right? Thereafter, what will be the next term? X raised to power 4 by 4 factorial. F 4 0. Then, x raised to power 5, 5 factorial. F 5 0. Right? So, similarly, here, f raised to power 4, I mean, 4 time derivative is 4 time derivative is 0. So, cancel this term. Thereafter, x raised to power 5, 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So, 4 times 3, 12 times 5, 60 times 2, 120. And this is, what have you got when you differentiated 5 times, 16. So this is your final answer. You can 4 times 4. So you have got x cube plus x raised to power 5 by 15. Because you have the question has asked you that you need to find out only the terms containing up to x raised to power 5, right? That's why this is your answer. I hope you understand how to expand according to Maclaurin series. In our next video, we'll discuss about Taylor's method. Okay, Taylor's theorem. Till then, take care of yourself. And if you like this video, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Bye.